Hello everybody, I'm Adriana and with Leonardo we want to welcome you to this course where we are going to learn how to solve a variety of breakdowns. We always have in mind this phrase, if you can't explain it simply, you haven't understood it enough. In this mobile repair course, we'll try to compress a lot of information in the shortest possible time. Here you'll find some of the tricks accumulated over the last 9 years that will lead you to successful repairs. Let's start by talking a little bit about measurement protocols. These protocols are used to evaluate, revise, and improve the measurement process. Have you ever thought about the benefits that the technicians get when they implement the standard of the measurement protocols? These protocols can improve the quality of service, optimize the repair process, and reduce time. In addition, a good measurement protocol can improve productivity, safety, and reliability of repairs. Measurement protocols are using tools from our workshop to guarantee the reliability of the result, so you don't have to invest thousands of euros for a good diagnosis. You just have to invest a little time in your training. It is essential to learn the measurement protocols to ensure the accuracy of the result. It's not always the PMIC or the EF-PMIC that fail. Therefore, we must be prepared to recognize and to revise any error that arises during the process. For a good measurement protocol, we have to know how to check the continuity, the voltages, the diode function, the current measurement, and finally the SMD component measurement. To establish a good analysis, we will start with the simplest, then we go with the intermediate, and finally we'll deal with the most complicated one. This strategy will allow us to address the subject efficiently and effectively, ensuring that all the parties involved understand the concept and procedures to follow. As a first step to find a failure, we recommend to perform a continuity test. This will help us to find if there are any interruptions in the electronic circuit. We practically verify the connection between point A and point B. To find the continuity, this tells us if there is a connection between these two points. We can start by performing a measurement test on the battery pins to find if any of the main lines are short-circuit. Once verified, we will proceed to check if the other lines are in perfect condition. Testers and multimeters are measurement tools used to detect the electrical continuity between two points. For electronic circuits, continuity is a necessary condition for a circuit to work properly. Measuring continuity helps identify the damaged components, allowing to the technician to solve problems on the motherboard. To use a tester in continuity mode, first we need to connect the tester to the two ends that we want to test. If the circuit has continuity, the tester will emit a beep. If the circuit is open, the tester will not emit any beep. In some cases, a continuity mode tester can also emit a light indicator to confirm that the circuit is closed. Otherwise, it will not emit any light. To measure the voltages, we need to power up the device. This is the second step. If the device does not turn on, we need to inject voltages by applying the correct voltage and amperage with the laboratory power supply to the battery connector. To be able to carry out a diagnosis of a screen failure, it will be necessary to inject an electrical current and turn on the screen. This will allow us to measure the voltages that are being generated and find the problem that is causing it. To carry out a quality diagnosis, it is necessary to have a laboratory power supply and a tester to measure the device components. These tools will allow us to quickly identify the problems in the device and find the best solution. Also, once the necessary capital is available, it's recommended to invest some money in additional tools such as Power Z or an oscilloscope to obtain more precise and reliable result. But in the first years with these two tools, you'll have enough. That's how we all started. To obtain a precise measurement of the voltages, the black tip of the tester must be placed on the ground surface, and with the red tip we measure the desired component or line. The tester must be configured in voltage mode, in direct current, for accurate result. This technique can be applied to measure the main and secondary lines of the motherboard. Over the last few months, we have recycled some battery connectors. Each one is well identified by its model, so there are no problem to inject voltage. In this course, I will show you some other tricks to connect voltage to the motherboard directly on the main lines. For a good diagnosis protocol, it's necessary to follow these five steps. At first, it will cost you some work, but over time, everything will become automatic and will master the entire process perfectly.